So there were a couple steps that were involved in us deciding that it was time to commercialize the technology we had been working on. The first step was through a process funded by the National Science Foundation called the I-Corps. So the NSF has this pot of money called the I-Corps, and the whole purpose is to help academics like myself transition technologies from the lab out into the public, into the commercial sphere. And the big focus of the program is doing customer discovery and market research. So you actually get out of the lab, leave MIT, and talk to people in industry about the problems they were actually having in delivering genetic material into cells. And one of the big takeaways from this process, we interviewed over 100 people at 40 plus different companies, and they said, it's too slow. The process is too slow. It takes too long. It's too slow. Can you make it faster? So after hearing this problem, I recognized that the technology I was working on at the time didn't really solve the problem of it being too slow. And so we started thinking about ways we could speed up the process and make it a little bit faster. And so we did this by creating a continuous flow engineering method in which cells are always flowing while they're being engineered, rather than a batch-based process, which is what it existed before. And then we put that into a pipette tip, which is an architecture very familiar to biologists and immunologists and those working in labs. And after we did this, we made some prototypes and created data and started presenting at conferences. And after conferences, people from companies would come up to us and say, okay, where can we buy these? And there was no place to buy them because there was no company and there was no one selling them. And after the, you know, eighth or ninth person that asked this, we started thinking maybe someone should be able to buy it. And if someone's going to buy it, it's going to be us who's going to have to make it. And so at that point, we really started thinking about commercializing the technology. And as luck would have it, you might say, this is right around the time of 2017, and the engine has been formed. And we interviewed with them and told them about what we were trying to do. And ultimately, they invested in our company, and we were one of the first few investments for the engine. So I believe what the engine is looking for, they're looking for innovative, disruptive, industry-changing like technologies, and in spaces that are classically not as well funded. So things like therapeutics, there's a lot of money to fund a therapy. Or things like software, particularly software for the masses, there's a lot of funding for software. But they look at those areas that are perhaps less funded in industries where it's prime for disruption. So if you look at the technologies that have been funded by the engine, many of them are in spaces where there's an old established technology and the engine company is looking to disrupt the old way of doing things. So it's kind of a hard problem to work on because there are a lot of old habits and old habits die hard, but there's a big upside if they're successful. In the case of our company, I'll give an example. When we were first coming out, a lot of the investors that we spoke with talked to us about becoming a therapeutic company. The idea being, well, you have this novel delivery method. Why don't you leverage that method to become a therapeutic company? And part of it, I think, is they're thinking about the upside. The upside of someone that makes therapies is very high. But I also think they were kind of pigeonholing us into how they normally invest. They normally invest in therapeutics to kind of know the economics of how that works. But the engine saw the broader vision for the platform that we're working on and the problem that we're trying to solve. And lo and behold, just this year, we've started hearing about other funds that are devoting money just to the problems that we're trying to solve. But the engine invested in us 2 years ago. So I don't know how they did it, but the engine, you might say, they were very much on the forefront of seeing how the problem we were addressing would be industry-wide. Effectively, what other investors found, they were investing in therapeutic companies, and all the therapeutics companies were saying, yeah, we have a problem manufacturing. We have a problem manufacturing. We have a problem manufacturing. Manufacturing is effectively one of the top three risks for companies in the space of engineering cells for healthcare. And after hearing about manufacturing problems, some investors decided, well, we need to actually develop funds to go after manufacturing. The engine invested in us long before others saw that as a problem.